AEM 41-1403C and 41-1403P air intake systems are engineered to add horsepower and reduce restriction compared to OEM air intakes, and it comes with a lifetime limited warranty. AEM intakes utilize a reusable dry flow air filter. These oil-free filters are durable and very easy to clean. AEM 41-1403C and 41-1403P air intakes fit 2010 and 2011 Toyota Corolla models with 1.8-liter engines. See the AEM catalog or AEMintakes.com for complete model list and details. These air intake systems are not legal for highway use in California or other states adopting California emission standards. Check AEMintakes.com for up-to-date information on emissions legality for specific parts on specific vehicles. AEM power testing showed an estimated power gain of 6.9 horsepower at 5,700 RPM with this air intake installed on a 2010 Toyota Corolla with a 1.8-liter engine. Actual results will vary depending on the condition of the vehicle, mileage, weather, and other variables. Here's a comparison of the car's sound on the dyno with the stock OEM system versus AEM's air intake. AEM air intakes come with detailed instructions with pictures and diagrams. AEM intakes are engineered for specific vehicles to produce a safe horsepower increase. Preparing the vehicle. Make sure the vehicle is parked on a level surface. Set the parking brake. If the engine has run in the past 2 hours, let it cool down. Disconnect the negative battery terminal. Raise the front end of the vehicle with a jack. Refer to your owner's manual for proper jack and jack stand placement to properly support the vehicle. Support your vehicle using properly rated jack stands before wheel removal or while working under the vehicle. Do not discard stock components after removal of the factory system. Removal of the stock system. Read and understand these instructions before attempting to install this product. Failure to follow installation instructions and not using the provided hardware may damage the intercooler system, throttle body, and engine. Remove the plastic engine cover. Disconnect the positive battery terminal. Remove the battery and plastic battery tray. Refer to the owner's manual for specific details regarding battery removal. Pinch the hose clamp securing the PCV hose to the vent tube on the valve cover. Then, remove the hose. Unplug the MAF harness connector from the MAF sensor. Remove the MAF sensor harness clip from the air filter housing. Unlock the two clips at the back of the air filter housing. Loosen the hose clamp that secures the intake hose to the throttle body. Remove the intake hose and upper air filter housing from the vehicle. And then remove the filter element from the lower air filter housing. Remove the three bolts that secure the lower air filter housing to the vehicle chassis. Remove the bolt that secures the harness bracket to the back of the lower air filter housing. Remove the lower air filter housing. Remove the metal bracket from the harness. Lift the tab up and remove the bracket. Behind the headlights, locate the clip securing the intake duct. Remove the clip and then remove the duct. Locate the two bolts at the bottom of the vehicle that secure the lower portion of the plastic wheel well liner to the front bumper. Remove these two bolts. Remove the clip securing the wheel well liner to the inner fender, allowing it to hang down. Remove the two bolts and nut that secure the resonator box to the inner fender well. Remove the resonator box from the vehicle. Locate the air duct and hose assembly behind the driver's side headlight. Remove the bolt that secures the hose in its folded position. Remove the bolt that secures the air duct ribbed hose assembly. and then remove the assembly by sliding it out from underneath the vehicle. Installation of AEM intake system. When installing the intake system, do not completely tighten the hose clamps or mounting hardware until instructed to do so. Remove the MAF sensor from the stock airbox. Install the MAF sensor and ETI module onto the lower inlet pipe with the provided hardware. Once installed, connect the ETI module harness to the MAF sensor. Install the lower inlet pipe, securing the inlet pipe brackets with the provided hardware. Route the MAF sensor harness to the ETI module. Connect the harness connector to the ETI module. Attach the air filter to the lower end of the inlet pipe with hose clamp number 9444. Attach the throttle body coupler to the throttle body with a number 9444 and number 9440 hose clamp. Slip the double hump hose onto the inlet pipe, but do not completely tighten the number 9444 hose clamp. Install the grommet into the hole of the upper inlet pipe. Install the upper inlet pipe, ensuring it is evenly distributed into the coupler and hump hose. Secure the pipe in place by tightening the hose clamps. Slide the 5/8 inch hose over the 90 degree plastic elbow and secure it with the hose clamp. Press the exposed end of the plastic elbow into the grommet hole. Soapy water may ease the installation of the plastic elbow into the grommet. Attach the other end of the hose onto the PCV vent and secure it with the supplied hose clamp. Install the plastic battery tray, the battery, and the battery tie-down. Reconnect the positive battery terminal. Refer to the owner's manual for specific details regarding battery installation. Install the engine cover. Reassemble the vehicle. Fender liner and splash guard. Install the fender liner, lower splash guard, and any hardware that was removed in steps 2N through 2O. Failure to install the fender liner will result in diminished performance and increase the potential for engine damage due to water ingestion in rainy conditions. Install the driver's side wheel using the factory torque specification located in the owner's manual. Position the inlet pipes for the best fitment. Be sure that the pipes or any other components do not contact any part of the vehicle. Tighten the rubber mount, all bolts, and hose clamps. Check for proper hood clearance. Readjust pipes if necessary and retighten them. Inspect the engine bay for any loose tools and check that all fasteners moved or removed are properly tightened. Reconnect the negative battery terminal and start the engine. Let the vehicle idle for 3 minutes. Perform a final inspection before driving the vehicle. It will be necessary to check AEM air intakes periodically for realignment, clearance, and tightening of all connections. Failure to follow the above instructions or proper maintenance may void warranty. Go to AEMintakes.com to find products, download installation instructions, view dyno charts showing estimated horsepower gains, and for other product details.